Hi folks, Sirdar here for InfoWorld. In this episode of Dev with Sirdar, we're going to take a look at a common Python problem, circular imports, and some solutions for it. In Python, a circular import is when you have modules that each try to import some dependency from the other. Example being, module A tries to import something from module B, but module B is also trying to import something from module A. And this creates a deadlock, and the Python interpreter will, in these circumstances, throw an exception. Here's an example of this in action. I have here a simple project in which I have three modules. First is main.py, our entry point, which imports from A and B. A.py has the function afunc, and B.py has the function bfunc. Each of these functions executes the other. Now, if we try to run this code as is, we're going to get an error about a possible circular import. Reason being is that when we run this, the first thing this code will try to do is import from A. But A will then try to import from B, and then B will try to import from A, and so on and so forth. And as soon as the Python interpreter senses such a cycle developing, it will stop running the program to prevent any further infinite regress. Now, one way to fix this is to change the scope of our imports. Here's another version of the same example. In this version, we're not using from to perform our imports using A and B. We're just importing modules A and B wholesale. And we're using their namespaces as a way to refer to our functions. Now, I bet you're wondering, why does this approach work when the previous one didn't? Well, here's why. When we say from X import Y, the module we're importing from has to be completely initialized in order for this to work. But if we just say import X, we're not accessing any symbols inside the module X at that moment. And so a circular reference doesn't get created at import time. Another way that we can rework the scope of our imports is to move imports out of the module level scope and into the scopes where we need them. Here's an example of what I mean by this. So instead of having our imports at the top level of the module, outside the functions, we're performing them inside the functions where they're actually needed. Now the performance cost of running the import every time we run the function is actually pretty negligible. Once you import something, it's cached. And so future imports for the same thing will just refer to the cached copy. In fact, if we don't use this function very often, this will speed up the importing of the module as a whole because we're not performing that import until it's actually needed. Now, there's one downside to this approach. It only really works if our imports are confined to the local scopes where they're needed, like inside the functions. If we need the imports to happen at the top level of the module because we also refer to them at the top level, this approach will not work. But that brings us to a third way to fix this issue, which is to simply rework our code to avoid circular imports between modules. We take the code that would be cross-imported and we all move it into one common module so there are no cross-imports. So in this example, we've done just that. We've taken all the code that would normally be split across multiple modules, we've pulled it together into a single module named funcs. And this way the functions can refer to each other freely, because we don't need to define the name of a function before we call it when we're inside another function. All of that can be handled after the fact. And since we don't import anything, we don't have to worry about circular imports at all. Now, the downside to this approach is that a single unified module can become large and unwieldy. But number one, that's not universally the case. In a case like this, the code is simply not big enough to cause a maintenance problem of that magnitude. And number two, sometimes the maintenance cost of one large module, where dependencies aren't all tangled up, is lower overall than the maintenance cost of many modules where you don't really have a good idea of what the interdependencies are like. So to sum up, circular imports in Python are when two modules each try to import something from the other in a way that causes an infinite import loop. And you can address this by changing the scopes of the imports, as I've demonstrated, or by rewriting your code to entirely avoid cross-importing. And since these approaches all have different implications and maintenance costs, you're going to want to take a look at which one of these is going to be a best fit for the scenario you have. So that's it for this video. If you like it, leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to the Dev with Sirdar channel on YouTube. And for more videos and articles, be sure to follow me on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.